Forgetting to review existing life insurance policies. Okay, so this is critical. This is especially important for you new guys. I know you're focused on making the sale. I know you're all studied up on your products. You want to make sure you got everything down pat. You're ready to roll. But here's the thing. Anecdotally, looking back over all the people I've sold, experienced agents will tell you this too in the final expense business. I would say there's probably somewhere between, well, I don't know, about half the people I sell a policy to had coverage to begin with. And the thing is sometimes when you sell a policy to these people, they've got inferior coverage. They've got the company named after the American president. You know what I'm talking about? Premium's this high, coverage is this low. Maybe you can do something better with it and get it up more in coverage, less in premium. But if you don't do a policy review, you won't necessarily know what the facts are. And this is the other thing. There's nothing better that sells what it is that you're trying to sell than getting the facts from the horse's mouth. And what I mean by that is when you get the policy and you review it, you look at the information. You make claims when you're a salesperson, right? My policy is the best insurance policy. Yeah, okay. You know, my policy is great. It does this and that. Well, those are all claims until they're substantiated. Now, some people will buy based off of claims, but I always think, well, there's people that won't, so I better just sell towards the hardest person and give as much preponderance of proof as I can. Very important principle in selling. So when you grab a policy and you do a review and you show them what they have, half the time they don't have what they think. But then when you get to show them, ah, Mr. Jones, you see your policy here, it's actually a 2-year wait. Your insurance agent said it was coverage. You see right here, no coverage 2 years. And they're like, dang, man, I didn't know that. And then you see where that premium is. You thought you had 10,000. That face amount's actually 7,000. So I got a 2-year wait and it's 7,000, not 10,000. That's right. Now you tell me what is going to sell your policy better than when they realize at that moment that their policy stinks and the other guy in the door completely screwed them over. Okay. This is why it's critical to sell or at least to review existing coverage, because you will unearth sales opportunities, whereas most people are just completely fine. They're content. Hey, I got a policy. It did fine for me. Why am I going to go the extra mile and do all this, blah, 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 blah. But then when you develop need because you've uncovered need, bingo. Really important for you new guys. And so how do you ask for a review of a policy? It's kind of like, I don't know, it's like asking for a date, I guess. You don't go up to the girl and ask the date without kind of getting to know her a little bit. Kind of getting to know, do a little presentation, if you know what I mean. Get kind of down to business and get to know each other a little bit. Be a little intriguing, get them engaged, and then you do it, right? Well, it's the same thing when you're asking for a policy review. So I don't go out the gate and ask for a policy review. I build a little rapport. I introduce myself, right? I demonstrate my knowledge. I demonstrate my position as what I do and how it benefits them. And somewhere along the lines of the pre-qualification phase, as I'm asking the questions to say, oh, by the way, who do you have your existing coverage with? That's the first question I ask because it presumes they have coverage. So either they're going to say, no, I don't have any, or yeah, I do. I've got it with XYZ company. So I say, okay, cool. Can you grab your policy? Because here's the thing. Before I make any recommendations as a professional, I think it's important to just make sure we're on the same page with what you have and how it works. Can you go grab that for me? They'll most of the time go get it. If they claim they can't find it because they live in a hoard pile and they can't find anything or they don't want to get it, then just say, great, that's fine. What company are you with? If they don't know, grab their bank statement, see what company's on there, and call the company and ask for their permission for three-way to review the information of the policy on the phone. So if you call customer service up, you'll always have somebody in most cases where the company will, as long as the person's on the line, they verify themselves and give them permission, you can get all the facts on the policy, the price, the premium, how it works, blah, blah, blah. And you can, again, using third-party validation, the professional from the insurance company is telling you that this company is not what it was supposed to be, if that's the case. It's going to give that much more standing and ability for you to help these people out. And again, largely because they appreciate you to go the extra mile to explain things to them in a substantive, constructive way that they otherwise didn't get. So it's very powerful that you do a policy review like this and make sure you do it every single call. You'll learn more about your competition, you'll do better, you'll make more sales, and you'll help more people out.